In the later 40s, when Diddy Levine lived with Eunice King, he gave her the ring that she wore. Janice, the smiling daughter, who came from a marriage way before, but Eunice was the father that she always saw. Though they never, 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 never told her, she always knew the score. You see, kids were so much wiser after the wars. But Diddy hadn't had enough. She had to get some more. On a razor piece of paper, she wrote Eunice, I'm not sure. And with a child in her arms, she went looking for a fling. Besides, she didn't like the name Mrs. King. First time that she heard Dapper Dan was on the radio, crooning at the volume that was way, way down low. Diddy was surprised to hear that Dapper Dan was dead. Soon after, he was a calling, and he asked the babe to plead it for a hand. Dapper's heart was dappered when Diddy answered, no, 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 no. But if she changed her mind, she said, Dapper, I'll let you know. With a child in her arms, she went looking for a man. Besides, she didn't like the name Dapper Dan. Queen, through all mother's lovers, she kept the name Levine. Behind the picture house, she first made her scene. She liked a boy called Alistair, who was dating a friend called Celine. And Celine wasn't mad when Janet came in between. But Alistair got scared when he heard, and he joined the USA Marine. Inheritance, you see, runs through every family. Who is to say what is to be? Is any better? Over and over.